Yeah.
And now you're kind of leading the team as the interim. How did that process happen?
In terms of me working with the team?
Well, becoming me, I mean, you're already in the front office, and I think
that's
you probably
right.
have something to say about the decisions that get made, and then you're the interim, but you kind of put your hand up, say, I want to do this. When did the kind of idea come for you?
So, from the beginning of this project, the idea was to go forward with this group. We had two successful years under our current coaching staff. This year, we've had some challenges. The team still has a lot of quality and a lot of opportunity within it. Once we realized we weren't quite getting the results, we felt like we had to make a change. The club decided to make an internal change because I think with the limited time that we have, it makes actually more sense that we try to fix this from within. I do have a familiarity with all of the players. I do have a familiarity with all of the staff. And I have a good familiarity with the league. So it seemed to be a very good situation for everybody.
Were there times this season where you watched decisions being made from the technical area or squad selection, you said, I could do better?
No, I say we have to do better. I don't say that I have to do better. We handle all of these decisions as a club, as a team. Our support of the coaching staff hasn't changed. So I was not in that mindset.
And Dan said yesterday he would consider you as a candidate long term. Is that your ambition? Would you like this job in 2022 and going forward?
Absolutely.
What did you want to start? What kind of tone did you want to set with today's training, and what kind of things did you want to work on in the practice today? As you kind of, you know, the guys know you, but
right.
they don't know you as a coach.
Right. First of all, I wanted them to be confident. I wanted to let them know that we have the quality to do this. But I think what they're understanding is we're going to bring another level of intensity and discipline, and just the willingness to not lose. And perhaps some things might get sacrificed in that style a little bit, but for sure they're gonna present a team that's gonna go out fighting.
Last one for me, Marco. Dan said yesterday that the reason this change was made now is that he feels this is still a playoff team this year.
Mm-hmm.
You might have to win all eight games for that to happen. How do you kind of look at the challenge that you're facing?
I have to win against Vancouver. So that's the message to the team. We have to go win against Vancouver. So we're not talking about playoffs, we're talking about winning the next game.
Marco, en español para todo el mundo. Pues en primera, ¿cómo te sientes de tener ahora la responsabilidad del primer equipo? Te vemos de regreso en la cancha, te veíamos con Oscar Pareja y el equipo de Oscar Pareja ahí abajo
sí.
como asistente de él. ¿Cómo te sientes ahora tú de estar encargado del primer equipo?
Gracias, bueno, con mucho orgullo, también con mucha responsabilidad, pero yo sé que este grupo tiene mucha calidad. Y todavía tenemos un gran oportunidad de ponerlo mejor en la cancha. Y yo estoy acá para apoyar el grupo, los jugadores, y presentar un grupo que va a luchar.
¿Qué es lo que vamos a ver diferente de este equipo? Porque sigue siendo el mismo equipo que tenía Luchi, pero ¿qué es lo que vamos a ver diferente de ellos?
Bueno, esa actitud de sacrificio, esa actitud de pasión, de intensidad. Todos los chicos tienen un poco de dolor por el torneo en este momento y qué pasó con nuestro grupo. Nosotros siente eso, pero también todavía tenemos un oportunidad de poner más esfuerzo y vamos a hacer eso.
Se hablaba acerca de la posibilidad de entrar a la postemporada, algo complicado pero no imposible. ¿Cuál es tu mensaje para ellos y realmente crees tú que sí se puede llegar a esta postemporada?
Sí, claro. Yo tengo que tener ese confianza en el grupo y la posibilidad, esperanza. Pero también yo soy realístico y en ese sentido, el primer partido contra Vancouver es lo más importante. Y ahí es donde tenemos que demostrar nuestro camino.
Mucho se ha señalado de que el equipo es muy joven, que tiene jugadores muy jóvenes
sí.
y demasiados jugadores de la cantera con poca experiencia. Uh-huh. Y los de experiencia los veíamos afuera de la cancha. ¿Eso crees tú que le ha pasado factura al equipo? ¿Estás contento con eso o crees que eso tiene que cambiar un poco?
No, bueno, yo pienso que tenemos un buen mezcla en el camarino de jugadores de que son veteranos y que son jóvenes y que están haciendo cosas pero muy bien en la cancha. Puede ser que vamos a usar otros en una manera diferente, distinto, pero de verdad yo soy muy cómodo con el vestuario.
Una pregunta más, just one more question. Mm-hmm. ¿Qué diferencia vamos a poder ver en tu estilo a lo que veíamos posiblemente con Oscar Pareja? Porque estuviste muchos años con ellos. ¿Va a ser un equipo similar o va a haber algo distinto?
Vas a ver cosas que son similar, obviamente. Yo fui encargado de la defensa en esos años, entonces va a ser algunas fases del partido que vas a reconocer, pero yo pienso también tenemos otro grupo distinto en la manera de ataque, en la manera ofensiva, entonces puede ser que va a ser un poco más distinto de ese grupo. Okay.
There's a big group out today with North Texas and yeah, Academy guys.
That's right.
What was the purpose of that? Is something we can see more often going forward?
Sparring is part of our culture. We've been limited in that due to protocols with the pandemic. But it's a great way to activate both groups 100%. It's really very multi-purpose. What I love out of those sessions is I'm getting the best out of both sides. The attacking players from North Texas are giving the defense a fantastic session, and same thing is true on the opposite side where we're doing the attacking functional against the defenders from North Texas. So I love that. I love that integration. It's part of our culture here at FC Dallas. It makes us very, very successful. Again, unfortunately, we had to do without it for a period of time. But yeah, you'll see it as much as we can do it.
Yesterday in the press conference, Dan and Andre spoke a lot about your abilities as a defensive coach. Mm-hmm. Is that one of your main messages, solidifying the defensive, and how are you doing that this week?
Yeah, well, through training, we're focusing on defensive concepts. And it's one area that we have to definitely improve. The rest of the part of our game is still building, but you know, we've been pretty successful getting the ball in the back of the net. So just defensively, we're going to shore up some things, and I think the overall attitude of the group, you're going to see what is already a good group, you're going to see an improvement.
Last one for me, and I'm interested in the roles of your coaching staff in terms of Peter, Chewy, and et cetera.
Yeah.
Like, have their roles shifted at all, or what's the breakdown?
A little bit, and I can just honestly say that they are extremely important to the group and definitely to me. As you know, my history as an assistant coach, sometimes those guys do the heavy lifting. These guys are going to be relied on even more to do heavy lifting. And in terms of Peter, you know, he's going to be working with the backs and the midfield along with me. Our attacking unit's going to be working with Profe Vera. Drew's going to take care of his goalkeeper stable as always and work with our set pieces. We're all going to make a collaborative effort to work together. But we're going to have specific attention to our lines. We're going to have guys that are focused with those players all the time in terms of doing sessions, in terms of doing videos, and in terms of doing extra IDPs after training.
Marco, una última pregunta, sorry, one more question. ¿Vamos a poder ver más en tu esquema posiblemente a Franco Jara o poder ver posiblemente a los dos, a Jara y a Pepe juntos en algún momento?
Sí, todo es posible. No, todo es posible. Y fue oportunidades con los dos en la cancha en el mismo tiempo. Entonces, nosotros vamos a presentar un grupo que está listo para ganar el partido. Y si yo elige que vamos con uno o otro o los dos, vamos a verlo.
Thank you, Marco. Appreciate
it. Thanks so much.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you, guys.